Welcome to several examples of simplifying perfect nth roots, most of which contain variables. When simplifying radicals, it's extremely important that we're aware of the index of each radical. So for this first example, we have the cube root of 8, so the index is 3. Next, we have the square root of y to the 4th. Because it's a square root, the index is not listed, which means the index is 2. And then for the 4th root of x to the 4th, the index is 4. The reason the index is so important is a radical reverses the operation of raising a number to a power. So to simplify the cube root of 8, we need to ask ourselves what number to the third power would be equal to 8. So if we can just think of that and know the number is 2, we're done. The cube root of 8 is equal to 2. But if we can't, let's talk about a process for simplifying the cube root of 8. This radical is going to simplify if 8 contains 3 equal factors. So what we'll do is look at the prime factorization of 8. Well, we can write 8 as 2 times 2 times 2. And because the index is 3, we're looking for 3 equal factors, which we have right here, which means this is the perfect cube factor of 8. Therefore, this will simplify to just one factor from the group, simplifying perfectly to just 2. So if this work is helpful, we should show it. Again, the reason why the cube root of 8 is equal to 2 is because 2 raised to the power of the index, which is 3, is equal to the radicand, or the number underneath the radical. So for the square root of y to the 4th, we want some expression squared that's equal to y to the 4th. So when dealing with variables, that question might be a little more challenging, so it's probably going to be helpful to show the work as we did here when the radicand was a number. So for y to the 4th, we would have 4 factors of y, and because the index is 2, we're looking for groups of 2 equal factors, because those would be the perfect square factors. So when simplifying, this simplifies to 1 factor of y, and so does this. So the square root of y to the 4th is equal to y squared. The reason for this is, this expression, y to the 2nd, raised to the power of the index, which is 2, does equal the radicand, which is y to the 4th. And for the third example, notice how the index is 4, so we're looking for what expression raised to the 4th power would be equal to x to the 4th. And again, if we can just think of that and know it's going to be x, we're done. But if not, we need to show work. So we'll go ahead and expand x to the 4th as 4 factors of x. Because the index is 4, we're looking for 4 equal factors, which we have here. Therefore, it simplifies just 1 factor of x. And again, the reason for this is x raised to the power of the index, or 4, is equal to our radicand, which is x to the 4th. But there is one more thing to mention about this last example. Whenever simplifying a radical that contains variables, if the index is even, like we have here, and the exponent on the simplified expression is odd, this is x to the 1st and 1 is odd, we do need to include absolute values around the simplified expression. So this should be the absolute value of x, unless we're told that x is always greater than 0. The reason for this is, when the index is even, the number underneath the radical must be positive, and the result must also be positive as well. Notice if x was equal to, let's say, negative 2, this would be positive 16, which is fine, but without the absolute values, we would be saying that this simplifies to negative 2, which cannot be the case. So the absolute values takes care of the cases where x is less than 0. Again, it's only needed when the index is even and the exponent on the simplified expression is odd. Notice in this example here, the index was even, but the exponent on the simplified expression was also even. Therefore, we did not need the absolute value. Okay, if you want to see some more examples of these, please take a look at part 2. I hope this was helpful.